Hello guys, and welcome to another flight review of mine. I'm now at Sydney Airport. 2 days ago, I flew in Rex Airlines business class from Melbourne to Sydney. Today, I'm going to fly in Virgin Australia's business class to Melbourne. Both airlines charge the same price on this route. I'd like to find out which airline offers a better product. Let's go.
I did a poll on my Instagram the day before my flight. The result was fairly close, with 57% of the people who voted preferred to fly Virgin's business class over Rex's. Virgin Australia, the second largest airline in the nation, has a fleet of 59 Boeing 737 aircraft. Virgin uses Terminal 2 at Sydney Airport. The check-in area is next to Rex Airlines. The airline offers self-check-in kiosks, however, you'll still need to drop your checked luggage at a staffed check-in counter. Virgin offers a priority check-in lane for business class passengers, Velocity Platinum and Velocity Gold members.
Hello. Melbourne, 6 o'clock. Is it too early?
Just like the car seat on the belt. There's no power bank, any spare batteries, matches, lighters in your bag?
No.
The check-in process was fast and simple. From printing my boarding pass to check-in my luggage only took them 40 seconds. Also, I came from Canberra this morning, so I arrived at the airport at about 4 hours before the scheduled departure time. I actually didn't expect them to be able to check me in this early. A big thumbs up to the check-in staff. Virgin Australia has a lounge at Sydney Airport. It was closed due to COVID and reopened in December 2020. Usually, the Sydney Lounge offers a premium entry, which provides direct curbside access, optional valet parking, flight check-in, and dedicated security screening point. Virgin advertises its premium entry as just steps away from the Virgin Australia Lounge, but worlds apart from the traditional airport experience. So I was actually really excited to enter via the premium entry. But the reality is, instead of being greeted by one of Virgin's team members, I was greeted by the barrier. After going through the traditional airport experience, I mean passing through a security check, the Virgin Australia Lounge is right next to it. I have to be honest that this is my first time being here, so I was a bit lost. While others were talking to the staff at the reception, I saw a self-checking machine that was unoccupied, so I just scanned my boarding pass and walked into the lounge. I headed straight to the buffet area, and the buffet attendant there was very helpful and patient. I told him that this was my first time being here. He then spent about 2 minutes explaining to me how to order food, order beverages, and today's meal options.
Here we have cheese and tomato, choice of cornmeal or white bread. Cheese and crackers here, two food on top. This side we have a selection of chips, cookies and chocolate. Feel free to just do anything you want. Cold drinks and coffee, none of that.
Thank you.
I was going to take a video of the food choices, but the lounge was really full and there were already people lining up behind me. Therefore, I decided to wait until it gets quieter. I then headed to the bar, ordered a glass of Coke, and found probably the last available seat in the whole lounge. Let's have a look at the food option. This footage was taken an hour later when the lounge got quieter and after gaining permission from one of the attendants at the buffet. The main meals are two sandwiches, chicken with spinach or cheese and tomato. You can see they forgot to leave a space between the word with and spinach in the menu. It's a very obvious mistake. The snacks include chips, biscuits, chocolate brownie, and fresh fruits are red apples and green apples. Here is a chicken spinach sandwich and a bowl of honey soy chicken chips. The bar, on the other hand, is fully functional with a wide range of beverages. At about 4:30, the lounge got a bit quieter, so I headed to the buffet and asked the staff if I could take a video for my YouTube flight review. She said, yes, sure. From her instant response, I believe I'm not the only person who filmed the food at this lounge. After that, I went to the bar and asked the same question. It was the manager that was the bartender. He said filming in the lounge poses a security risk, and he said he would allow me to film it if I went to the reception and got permission from the manager there. So I did.
Hi, I'm a YouTuber. I'd just like to take a video of the lounge and want the manager to come.
She answered with a no straight away, and I could see the despise shown on her face. I saw people were lining up behind me again, therefore I stopped further trying. As I was on my way back to the lounge, she didn't forget to stop me and ask me if I had lounge access. It actually hurts my feeling. How did I get in if I didn't have lounge access? Are you suggesting that I sneaked in earlier? This is such a wonderful customer service from the management of Virgin Australia Sydney Lounge. After confirming that I was allowed to be here, I walked back to the bar and ordered a glass of champagne and a glass of Coke. While pouring the drink, the bar manager asked me if I got permission. Well, clearly I didn't. I said no. He said thought so. And he poured the Coke without putting in ice cubes until I asked him to do so. So that was my experience at Virgin Australia Sydney Lounge. The lounge staff who are trained very professionally, I reckon the managers need to undergo some training too. In addition, saying filming in the lounge is a security risk isn't really convincing. There are so many people that filmed and shared their lounge experiences on social media, and there's no sign that says no filming in this lounge. I personally think it's just this manager that was being grumpy on that day. Anyway, now let's head to the boarding gate. The aircraft that will be taking me down to Melbourne today is a Boeing 737-800. This aircraft, VH-YFR, is the 100th Boeing 737 delivered to Virgin. The rally to 100 includes the 737-300 and 400 jets operated by the airline during its early years as Virgin Blue.
We invite business class guests, economy guests, platinum and gold members of Velocity, and other four members of our partner airline loyalty program. To board now, you have using our priority lane for gate 33.
Perfect, thank you.
Hello. Thank you. Thank you for the ride.
Virgin offers priority boarding for business, Velocity Platinum, Gold and Economy X passengers. That's around 50 passengers, almost a third of the plane that gets priority boarding. That's too many people. My suggestion is that they should allow business class passengers to board first, then the Platinum, Gold and Economy X passengers.
Hello.
How are you going?
Thank you. Two on the right. I'll be shortly. Hello.
There are two rows of business class seats on this aircraft in a 2-2 configuration. The first row has less legroom due to the bulkhead at front. The leather seat has a width of 19.5 inches, a pitch of 38 inches, and a recline of 5 inches. The recline isn't really much. There's a slide-out cocktail ledge between the seats, and below it are the power plugs, but they weren't working on this flight. At the front of the seat is a massive adjustable headrest and an engraved Virgin logo in the center.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome aboard the 874, we're off to Melbourne. My name is Jess, your onboard leader. To get to the rest of the day, we're happy to have you with us.
Hello and welcome on board this Virgin Australia Boeing 737-800. Please pay close attention while we get you ready for takeoff. As we're ready to leave, fasten your seatbelt low and tight around your hips. To fasten, push both ends together.
Thank you.
Virgin's newer Boeing 737s are installed with mood lighting, which is designed to convey a relaxing environment. The tray table is stored inside the armrest. I received a welcome drink on my business class flight with Rex Airlines. I was expecting the same on Virgin, but it turns out that they don't do it anymore. Upon boarding, you can collect a pack which includes a face mask and a wipe. One reminder is that it is a refreshing wet wipe that contains 99.29% aqua, which is water, so it's not an antibacterial wipe. Now let's have a look at the business class meal service on Virgin Australia. The flight departed Sydney at 6 p.m. I was expecting a hot dinner meal, but in reality, I was given a snack box. In terms of the beverages, I wanted to have a glass of champagne, but they didn't have it. The cabin manager didn't offer any alternatives, so I just asked for a can of Coke.
Do you have sparkling one?
Sorry. That's a Coke. Coke? Yourself, sir? Let's see what's inside the snack box. I'm not very excited. Here we go. So this is a selection of delicious prepackaged foods appropriate to the time of day that Virgin gives to its business class passengers. Inside the box, there are a pack of barbecue chickpea, a pack of lavash bites with tomato chutney, and two chocolate brownies. To finish is a square piece of chocolate. After checking the price on the internet, I found that the chickpea costs about $1, the lavash bites costs $1, and the chocolate brownies cost $2. Well, the only good thing about the snack box is that everything is made in Australia. In terms of the Coke, it is served with a single-use plastic cup without ice cubes. Does Virgin really don't like providing ice cubes to its customers? Ah, and the Coke was in room temperature. We are now flying over Kosciuszko National Park. It contains mainland Australia's highest peak, Mount Kosciuszko, Cabramatta, the highest town in Australia, and Parrish's Ski Resort, the largest ski resort in the Southern Hemisphere. Let's have a look at the in-flight entertainment. The Wi-Fi still remains off, but you can access to Virgin's entertainment on your own device if you downloaded the app before takeoff. It offers a range of movies, TV shows, and audiobooks. The moving map feature allows you to track the plane's location, altitude, speed, and the estimated time of arrival. The flight time today is 1 hour and 6 minutes. The flight overall was smooth, but clearly I wasn't happy with the meal on board. Before Rex entered the domestic market, Virgin charged around $500 to $700 on this route, if not more. But the meal box they provide only worth around $5. Furthermore, the power plugs didn't work for the duration of the flight. I have made a Rex Airlines business class review on the same route, so please feel free to check it out. What do you think about Virgin Australia? Please leave your thoughts in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please feel free to leave a dislike if you don't agree with me, and please subscribe to my channel if you like my style of reviewing flights and trains. I'll see you guys in my next video.